Hi everybody, tis I. I am back and I'm going to do a little experimenting. I made a whole nother video and unfortunately it didn't do so well because I had my old setup and I was trying to use my phone or my camera and it just wasn't having it. So please excuse this because, you know, I've got my computer sitting over here. So you see the wires, it's real pretty, but anyway. Just ignore all that. But this is what I'm working on. And I started on this yesterday. And I wanted to tell you or catch you up to speed as to what I'm doing. This is a steampunk themed junk journal, excuse me. And I'm making this for my sister. And what I did was I found a Reader's Digest condensed book. And I just pulled the guts out of it. And I had some stamperia paper, I guess. And what I did was I just lined most of the book with this. And this is the original cover here that's peeking through. So see, I tore it down the middle there. And these, let me see if I can show you this real quick. I found these amazing, amazing paper dolls on Etsy. And if I can remember, I will link the shop below because these are just so amazing. I saw these and I was just like, I had to have them for my sister. I just thought they were brilliant. So anyway, all of these paper dolls, and you can see my little bucket here full of my, that's trash. Trash is for free. But anyway, I have a little bucket here full of all my little steampunk, stuff that I've been cutting out a little bit along to go in this journal. But this is where this came from. That's what she originally looked like, and that's what I've done to her. So, so once I glued everything down, and here's the inside, that's just, stamperia paper, and that's the, this is actually the, fly page for the original book. I just tore it off the pages and put it in the middle, and it matched, and it was there, and it was available, so this is, this is the other side, and I made a little boo-boo down here. I don't know if you can tell, but it looks a little crooked, so I've got to fix that. But I'm going to put a pocket there anyway. But on the back here is another one of those paper dolls. Isn't that just gorgeous? I just love it. It's like my favorite thing ever. So that's down. And then I took some of this stuff, this Mod Podge. It is antique matte Mod Podge. It's a water-based sealer, glue and finish. You know, I needed to seal this book for the experiment that I'm about to perform on this poor lady. So I used this. I don't ordinarily like Mod Podge because I find it a little sticky, but actually this isn't too bad. I don't know if they fixed their formula or because it's matte, maybe it's not so sticky. I'm not sure, but so anyway, I layered it in the antique matte. Then I had a bunch of gears that my sister gave me, oddly enough. I think she was dropping subtle hints. What do you think? And I just took, let's see, got it over here, pardon me. I took some E6000 and I just put the gears all over it and let it sit up and dry. So that's all I've done to it so far. So you with me? All right, now for my little experiment, and we'll see how this goes. And I'm still playing with this camera, forgive me. I want to make sure I get you in frame. I have epoxy resin. I've never used this stuff before, but sometimes you get a vision and you just have to go for it. So this is why I'm gloved up. And I have my little surface down here. My plan is not to pour resin on this. My plan is actually to paint the resin on and then keep layering it, if that makes sense. So I get this a little more propped up so you can see it. So I don't know how it's going to work. I've got some glitter and stuff and some little stars I thought would be cute. And I know this takes a lot of time to do this in layers. I don't expect to pour it or paint it or whatever all in one go. So I'm just going to try a little bit along and see what happens. So You guys are with me on this, right? So I've got these little graduated cups, I guess. They're edumacated, the graduated. Very funny. All right, so let's see what we do with this stuff. Lord help me. I hope my husband doesn't come up here and find me passed out. Because I don't think my insurance is paid up. My life insurance. He might be sadly disappointed. All right, so that one's open. Let's open this one. I got a Carol Burnett package going on here. Do y'all remember the Carol Burnett episode where she goes in and she can't open any of the packages? You know, she goes from Band-Aids to milk and she can't open any of them. All right, so here we go. I'm going to pour to that. I won't pour too much. I think I'm going to pour to that first little line because it really, it's just like the first layer. I don't want a whole lot. I'm following the directions as instructed. Sticking my head in here. All right, let's see if I can get this about the same. Just want to cover that bottom. Make sure those are about even. Now, this is real scientific. I think I have more of this than this. Yeah, I should have marked cups. Oh well, doesn't turn out. I'm not going to cry about it. Alright, and then we'll pour team one in here. I said I didn't want to use a whole lot, and I'm expecting to ruin a paintbrush in this experiment too, so I certainly don't want to waste any of this precious stuff. Okay. Oh, stirry. Let's see what we cook. Gosh, I hope this turns out. I have a plan. I have a vision. Alright, I'm getting my old ratty paper towel over here and put that there. Alright, here's my brush. This is my plan. Y'all watching? I'm going to put the epoxy over the gears. Ruining this and making a complete mess. That's why I balanced my book a little bit over here because I didn't want it rolling down the side. And if you're doing this, or if you decide to do this, make sure, please, that you work in a well-ventilated area. You definitely don't want to be falling out with resin. And you can also, from what I have researched anyway, you can get sick from resin after, you know, prolonged exposure. Or heck, they're saying even after a mild exposure, so you want to wear gloves. All that being said, here we go. I've never seen anybody do any of this kind of stuff on a journal cover. I could be wrong, but I looked all over because I thought, well, that would be a cool idea. I wonder if anybody else has done it, and I just didn't see anything on YouTube, but that doesn't mean that, you know, nobody's done it. I'm sure they have. And I want to get this over here as much as I can. can through everything. My plan was kind of to do the, just do the gears. And I'm probably going to do more than one layer for sure. Okay. All right, so there we go. All the gears, let's see. Now, also in my little, I don't know why I always seem to end up with clear my throat up here, but I do not want to overdo it with this stuff because I just feel like I know that's kind of an everybody that does resin, it seems like, does this newbie mistake of adding all of this glitter and stuff, and it just kind of sinks. I don't know what I'm doing. Do I sound like I know what I'm doing? If I sound that way, just ignore me and just assume I know what I'm doing. Because I really don't. Put this under here, it's dripping. Ooh. Yes, that was a healthy dose of glitter in that one, wasn't it? Yes, it was. Okay. Now I'm going to do this. I'm going to add a few. I keep bopping the camera with my head. I hope I'm not getting my head in shot, too. Because you'll all chip in and buy me hair dye, I'm sure. Because, oh yes, I got some grays going on, let me tell you. We'll see how this turns out. Come on, Star. It doesn't want to come off. Now it comes out. Oh, thanks. Yes. I love you too. Alright, that's enough of that. I don't want to overdo it. Alright, so that paintbrush is probably toast, as are these. Those are toast too. I don't think I have any more in here. Add a few more sparklies. What the heck? You only live once, right? Okay, so now that's probably crap. Oh, I said a bad word. I'm sorry. Let's get my heat gun and see if we can blow out some bubbles, so to speak. Pretty. It's oozing. I have to save my book. Probably with my heat gun, right? Just make sure I get all of the icky poo off the side. I guess I can always recover this, the inside of, if I must. This works out. something a bit larger to hold that steady, I think. What have I got around here? Oh, I know. You probably are getting my head in my frame now. Yes, that'll work fine. Thank you. These little doohickeys right here, I got from Amazon. They were in some, they were packing material in a box, and I saved them, and I didn't know what I was going to do with them, so what I did was I put some sandpaper on them and made some sanding blocks. So let me grab a couple. That's what these are. So they're just sandpaper. All right, so that's where we are now, and I just have to kind of wait and let that sit up and see what that looks like. I'm going to give it several hours, and then I will come back and update you, and if it needs another little helping of resin, we can do that. But that's all I have for now. I just wanted to share it with you. Thanks. Hi, everybody. It's me again. I am here, and I have had time now to finish up this little experiment with the epoxy or resin that I was messing with earlier. I have let it sit for a while now, and then I put on a second coat, and then I did the other side of the book. So y'all ready for this? I'm not sure what I think about it. You can let me know in the comments what you think about it, because you know, it is what it is. But so I'm gonna show you what I've done, and then show you some of the things that I'm gonna be messing with in the next few days. I'm trying to hurry up and get this video in, as I have laundry cooking. Yes, laundry. So I have to go do the things. So here she is. Boop. Look at that. So what do you think? It turned out, I think it turned out pretty well, actually. You've got this lovely coating here that protects the book. I've got the glitter and the gears all covered, so they're not going anywhere. Of course, you can see the shine on it. Here's the back, shiny as well. I put one coat, I think I put one coat here, and I put like a couple coats here. So there she is. There's the cover of the steampunk junk journal. And I still have a lot of work to do. Like on the inside, I need to like put pockets and, you know, all that stuff. But there she is. So please tell me what you think. it was an experiment. Sorry, I keep clearing my throat. It's an experiment, and hopefully I'll get a little bit better at this resin thing. This was my first try, and when I put on the second coat, I even had enough left over. Look, excuse my little inky hands. I've been doing a lot today. But look, I did this little teeny weeny embellishment. Isn't it cute? I know, I need to get out more. But it's so cute. It's got little gears. Anyhow, I made that to probably go on the front here. We'll see. So anyway, did that. Now let's scoot this out of the way for just a second. Now, onto my basket of stuff. Whenever I do a new junk journal, I find it easier to cut everything up, get all my materials together that I want to put into my journal, and throw it into a basket. So I have a lot of these little baskets, and these are handy, like to take, you know, like to the living room or whatever with a pair of scissors and cut things up. So this is what I have so far. I have a lot of ephemera and stuff. I'm still learning how to use the little Cricut thing that my daughter bought me for Christmas, but I did manage to do this. Look, these are just little gears that I cut out of they're just like, I think it's just glitter paper on the Cricut, but those are going to be cool. I made a whole bunch of these to put in there. I'll just throw them down. Just throw them down. Yes. Yes. Throwing them down. So see, they're just tons and tons, and I made them in different colors. Like I made the white sparkles, And I wish I could. Maybe that's a bit better. Can you see a bit better? Hope so. Sorry. I'm trying to see through my viewfinder and also look at what I'm doing. I'm not that coordinated, people. Trust me. But these are all of the little gears. So I did all of those. And then I took, oh, look, more gears. I took a bunch of different kinds of printables, like, ooh, more gears. Who would have thought it? More gears. I took a bunch of different printables. I think I took some from like Graphic Fairy. Graphic Fairy has a lot of really nice steampunk type images. ooh, more gears. I found these. These are actually little domino strips. They're steampunk Graphic Fairy domino strips. I think I'm going to use these for belly bands. That was just a thought I had. Then I have some of my own images that I made in my printable. And it was really funny because when I went back and looked at this printable, I need to go back and fix it because there is so much that just needs to be fixed. This was one of my very first printables in my Etsy shop, and I need to fix this. But anyway, I did cut out some of the things from that printable. But I have that stuff. And then I have, there's another one of my printables. Here's some more of my printable. Yay! More of my printables. Woohoo! Look at that! Postcards from the edge. See? I love that picture. I think it's so cool. So just a whole bunch of various steampunk themed pictures. And then, of course, see this, like, Graphic Fairy. I mean, you can find images from all over the place. I do have some printables that I paid for in here, like, this is Stamperia. There's a lot of that. I really love their stuff. That's, like, one of my favorite papers to use. And I like the little sayings on this. This, the world of reality has its limits, but the world of imagination is boundless. And that is so true. So true and so wise. This is Victoria. Victoria. I bought this, I think. It's I think it's a steampunk offering that they have. Here's one of the tags from it. I just think that guy's really cool. And he's got a red bird on his head. I mean, can't argue with him. He's got a red bird on his head. There's some more of those. So these are all things that I have cut out and am getting ready to use, and I just find it a whole lot easier to get all my images together, all my little papers, and in this one too, I also have, let me get to it, I have created some stickers, and these were a little domino, let me get it the right way, domino tiles, you know, I've been on a domino kick lately, so I have a ton of these. But I made stickers out of them for my sister. I thought she would enjoy those. And then these are all images from Graphic Fairy. And I just put them on printable sticker paper. Like, this one's really cool. How cool is that? It's a sticker. And she can put all of this stuff in her journal herself. And it'll give her, you know, something to play with. So I'll do that, and then I'm going to put, you know, some of the paper dolls in there. I think I have those down at the bottom here somewhere. So these are just various things. See, loads! I have loads of stuff. Probably more than I'll ever use in this one journal, but there it is. So I have those. I just wanted to share that with you. Because I plan on trying to do this with you, if I can get this camera right. So over here I have my signatures kind of together. However, you'll notice that the book is this big and the signature is this big. So guess what I have to do? Yes, I have to go in and cut about, oh, I don't know, would you say it's about an inch and a half off of these papers? Which is fine. I mean, it'll give me something to do, but But I think these papers are going to look very nice in here. And they're just Stamperia and Victoria and Graphic Fairy and whatever I could find. So that's the majority of this stuff. And it's all, you know, steampunk based. I may even dye some tea-dyed paper. I'm not sure yet. I'll have to look and see what I've got going on. So, I'll probably cut down these papers before I talk to you the next time so that we can decide what we're going to do with the innards here. You know, if we're going to sew on here, if we're going to add some, you know, fold-outs, if we're going to add pockets, you know, what are we going to do? So, we're going to have a look at that maybe tomorrow, whenever I can get around to it. I'm doing my best. I got about 3 projects on the boil right now. So plus, you know, my granddaughter, my husband, and household chores, which are being neglected woefully. So, but I did want to be able to share this with you and to get some videos put out there. So anyhow, there's this. And we'll get started on her. I just wanted to show you what the results of the resin were. And I probably should show you. Hold on. This is the type that I got. This is, I'm not sure how you pronounce this. Puduo? Puduo? Puduo! There we go. Puduo. Epoxy resin. And this was about $16 on Amazon. And it comes with like gloves and little cups and stirring sticks. And the only thing that didn't come with it was a mask. And I also bought these little tiny molds. They were like $6, and that's where I got this from. And it only took just a tiniest little bit just to make this one little doodad. I just love him. He's so cute. So. Anyway, that's about it. That's what I've been up to. I appreciate you being here. Thanks so much. And I hope that you'll come with me on this adventure in making this particular journal for my sister. And yeah, so first experiment. Yay! Nobody died. That's the important thing. All right, take care. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.